Now you are ready to manage advanced issues regarding reconciling with customers. The most complex type of mistake to find and fix is finding and fixing a misapplied payment. This means that either you or the customer applied one of the customer's payments to the wrong invoice. There are specific symptoms or clues that show you that you have a misapplied payment. If you see these conditions, then you can have confidence that you know what the problem is and you learned in this video how to fix it. The clues are: the customer's total balance is correct, but the individual invoice balances one by one are different. If this is the condition, then you know for sure the only possible mistake that you can have is a misapplied payment. In our first example, we are comparing Candy's open invoice to our open invoice report. This blue box is Candy's open invoice report in Candy's computer. However, this part here is our open invoice looking at the Candy section. So you can see Candy would call us to complain about the differences between what we think are the open invoices and what she thinks are the open invoices. Look very closely at this condition. You may notice that the total balance that we both have for Candy is the same and is therefore probably correct. Both Candy and Holden agree that Candy owes $11,160 in total. However, when you look at the individual invoice balances one by one, you notice that the balance that Candy has for invoice number 10 is different than the balance that we have for invoice number 10. If you look a little more closely, you can also notice that what Candy has for the balance of invoice number 15 is different than what we have for the balance of invoice number 15. But even though we have two invoice balances different, the total that Candy owes us is agreed at $11,160. So what could have possibly caused this condition? Well, when we look more closely, we see that every difference we compare is different by $680. Think about it. The difference between Candy's number 10 and our number 10 is $680. The difference between Candy's number 15 and our number 15 is $680. In fact, if you look at the differences between the invoices themselves, you can see the difference is $680. In this case, we probably have misapplied one payment in the amount of $680. However, we still have to follow the official procedure for finding and fixing mistakes. To fix a misapplied payment, here's what you do. First, you open up the detail report. In our computer, that's the customer balance detail. Second, open each payment one by one. Start with the latest. Start at the bottom of the customer section in the customer balance detail and open only the payments. Third, compare the check marks in the payments to what the customer is telling you regarding where the payment should be applied. And if the customer disagrees with where you put the check marks, and if the customer wants the payment applied to a different invoice, then you have to uncheck the wrong invoices and recheck the correct invoices to reapply the payment. So let's imagine that the two QuickBooks files I have open are both mine and Candy's. Ours are in dark blue, and that would be Holden's records, and the title bar of every window in Holden's records will be the dark blue. However, in Candy's file, or at least the file that we're pretending is Candy's, the title bar will be light blue. Now in Holden's file, I will open the customer balance detail and adjust it so that we see only Candy's numbers. And these are Candy's numbers starting at the bottom. I will do the same thing in the file that we are imagining and pretending is in Candy's computer so that we can reconcile properly with this customer. Okay, so now we have Candy's customer balance detail open here, and we have our customer balance detail with Candy showing here. Now, the procedure says the following. Go to the very latest payment, double-click, and observe where the check marks are. We can see the February 17th payment was applied to invoice number 12 in our records. So let's close this out. When we go to Candy's records, she also has the payment for February 17th, 620. When we open it up, we see that in Candy's computer, she also has the February 17th payment applied to number 12. So since this payment was applied to the same invoice in our records and the customer records, this payment cannot be the source of the problem. We don't have to open an invoice because we know for sure the problem is a misapplied payment. So let's skip the invoice on February 14th. The next oldest payment is February 10. When I double-click the February 10 payment from Candy inside Candy's computer, Candy applied the February 10th payment to invoice number 10. Now, when I switch over to our records in our computer and we look at the February 10th payment, we see in our computer the February 10th payment was applied to invoice number 15. The February 10th payment is also $680, which is the amount that we saw was different when we compared the open invoice report. So once again, we have found the problem. Our February 10th payment was applied to applied to invoice number 15, but Candy's February 10th payment in her computer was applied to invoice number 10. If we assume the customer is correct, then I am switching back to our records, as you can see, dark blue window title bar, and I'm going to change what we have to be the same as what Candy has. I'm going to uncheck the wrong one and recheck the right one. I will unapply the payment to invoice 15 and reapply it to invoice number 10. Click Save and Close, save the changes, yes. Now, when I open our open invoice report and look at the section of Candy, each invoice one by one in our open invoice report should be the same as the open invoice report for in Candy's computer, but not just the total, the individual amounts one by one. Starting at the top in the section of Candy on the open invoice report, she has $760, $1,000, $2,000, $2,000, $5,400. And in our computer, in our records, starting at the top of Candy, we have the exact same thing. $760, $1,000, $2,000, $2,000, and $5,400. So now we have the total matching Candy's total, and we also have each individual open invoice balance one by one, matching each individual open invoice balance in Candy's computer one by one. Now Candy's records are correct. Sometimes the customer will call you to complain that the statement you sent is very, very, very different than what they have in their computer in their records. However, they still notice that the total balance that they believe they owe Holden in their computer is the same as the total balance indicated on the statement. Why? Why is it that the records are such a mess, but the total balance is correct. Well, in a case like that, it must mean that you have several misapplied payments. Have confidence, if the total balance is correct, that the only thing you have to do is find and fix misapplied payments. For example, customer Alan called you and complained that the statement you sent was not only inaccurate, but totally different. Let's take a look. Imagine on Alan's computer, when he looks at the invoices that he believes are unpaid and owed to Holden, they look like this. However, on the statement we sent him from our computer, Alan's open invoices for what he owes Holden looks like this. Now, it may look like all three invoices have the wrong balance. However, you must have confidence that the only problem is several misapplied payments. You know this for sure because the total balance of your records and the total balance in Alan's records are the same. So execute the procedures one by one until the individual invoices on the open invoice report match exactly. Now again, for this demonstration, I have two QuickBooks files open. Let's imagine the file with the red theme and all of the red title bars are Alan's computer, and let's imagine that the normal color with the normal theme is our computer. Hold on. We open the customer balance detail on our computer and make sure Alan's records are showing. And when you are on the phone with Alan, Alan will open his detail report and make sure every transaction since the last statement is showing on the screen. The procedure tells us to start at the very latest payment and open it up. February 22, a payment of $500 in Alan's computer was applied to the January 11th invoice number 9. So the February 22 payment of $500, Alan has applied to invoice number 9. However, in our computer, the February 22 payment for $500, as you can see, is also applied to invoice number 9. Therefore, the February 22 payment is not a problem. I'm going to close it out in our computer, and Alan on the phone with you will close it out in his computer. The next oldest payment is February 16th for $1,000. The February 16th for $1,000 in Alan's computer is applied to invoice number 13. However, that same payment, the February 16th payment of $1,000 in our computer, is instead applied to number 9. Aha! We found a difference. We have February 16th applied to number 9, but Alan has February 16th applied to number 13. Now again, we have to assume the customer is correct. So, that means we have to change our February 16th payment from number 9 to number 13. Let's go back to our computer and uncheck number 9 and recheck number 13. Now, our payment on February 16th looks just like Alan's payment on February 16th. So, Alan doesn't have to save his. He didn't change anything. We have to save our change and click yes. Now that we fixed a misapplied payment, let's compare the open invoice reports and see if they're the same. I open my open invoice report in Holden's computer, and of course we'll come back to Alan's computer and open his open invoice report, and unfortunately the numbers are still a little different. He has 500, 1500, and 2000, but we have 1000, 1500, and 1500. It must be that there is another misapplied payment somewhere. We know that for sure because the total balance in both sets of records is still $4,000. So let's close out the open invoice report and simply continue from where we left off. We check the oldest payment. We check the second oldest payment. Now let's check the third oldest payment. The February 13 payment of $500 for Alan. When we open it up, we see that Alan's $500 for February 13th was applied to the oldest invoice, number 5. In our records, the February 13th payment, also the third from the bottom, was instead applied to number 13. Boom. There's our difference. Again, we put the $500 that Alan gave us on February 13th towards invoice number 13, but the customer put the $500 that he gave us on February 13th to invoice number 5. If we assume the customer is correct, then we have to go back to the payment window in our computer and uncheck the wrong one, which is invoice number 13, and recheck the right one, which is invoice number 5. When we click Save and Close and Yes for the change, we can now see that our open invoice report for Alan matches Alan's open invoice report on his computer. Take a look. Invoice number 5 is 500, and in our records, invoice number 5 is 500. In our records, invoice number 9 is 1500, and in Alan's records, invoice number 9 is 1500. In Alan's records, invoice number 13 is 2000, and in our records, invoice number 13 is 2000. So have confidence that no matter how messy it looks, if the total balance is correct, you can definitely fix it by finding the misapplied payment and reapplying.